Ladies and gentlemen, let's kick it into high gear with the high show at MacGruber, Lieutenant Scott Lindahl. Right now, turn your attention to the right, where you'll now hear the Hornet's two GEF-404 turbofan engines go all the way to max power, delivering over 36,000 pounds of thrust. Once he accelerates, Lieutenant Lindahl will pull that Hornet straight up and go out of sight in a low transition takeoff run. Show center. He'll select full afterburner and pull up into the vertical, subjecting himself to 8 times the force of gravity. Let's watch him now as MacGruber approaches from the right in the Hornet, accelerating to nearly the speed of sound. And you're going to notice that you won't hear him until he passes through show center. On your feet, Pax River, and start cheering for Lieutenant Scott Lindahl of the F-18 Hornet TAC Demo's High Speed Pass. Of the F-18. As the Hornet reaches show center, he will soon pitch up to the vertical and execute a maneuver known as the double immolation. During the maneuver, the pilot will be subjected to about 6 times the force of gravity. This demonstration illustrates the incredible pitch authority and vertical maneuverability of the F-18. Approaching soon from the left, the Hornet will complete a staggering minimum radius turn, literally sucking Lieutenant Lindahl back into his seat. You've been on a merry-go-round, you know how hard it is to hold on? Well, at this point, Scott Lindahl will be trying to keep the blood from rushing to his legs. He'll want it to stay in his head so he can stay conscious. Let's watch him as he attempts the punishing Hornet minimum radius turn. Sometimes pitching flight deck. Navy and Marine Corps pilots are trained approach point. The speed allows only about 15 seconds to precisely adjust the flight path in order to touch down in an area not much larger than your own driveway. Notice, as the Hornet approaches, that the gear will be down, the tail hook will be extended. It is the tail hook that allows the Hornet to land atop and stop at about 400 feet. Right now, MacGruber is executing the carrier configuration pass. Momentarily, he's going to power up into another half reverse cubic. Let's watch. Aircraft. In a very short space, you will see the Hornet change direction from a horizontal flight path to straight up. It's this ability combined with an awesome arsenal of air-to-air weapons that make the Hornet a world-class fighter, feared worldwide. Exceptional slow speed capabilities of the Hornet. It's famous for its ability to fly slower than other comparable fighters. The F-18 Hornet remains completely controllable through the use of two flight control computers. MacGruber is now setting up for the slow speed pass by selecting maximum afterburner after this maneuver. He'll pitch up and go vertical and complete another maneuver known as the half cubit eight. But right now, let's check in live with Lieutenant Lindahl to see how slow he's going. Hey, Scott, Matt Jolly down here at the ground, buddy. How slow are you moving right now?
Hey, Matt, currently decelerating to 140 knots ground. 115 today.
Do you see the kid down here in the blue shirt?
Let me get the nose around. I'll take a look.
He's waving at you. Wants to be a fighter pilot someday.
That sounds awesome, Matt. Currently flowing through 130.
Wow, look at this.
There's a 120.
Precise power changes that the pilot will make as the aircraft is expertly guided onto the landing spot right at show center. Now today, We're going to be unable to do that because we can't. Right now, unfortunately, cannot land on the runway because it has not been accepted by the Navy. So we can't do the carrier style landing, but we can do the approach. Watch him now. The tail looks down, the flaps are down, the gear are hanging. He is ready to land just as he would aboard a U.S. Navy aircraft carrier. Watch now as he flies it all the way down to the deck, and at the last second, goes to full afterburner, sucks the landing gear up, and goes back around for his last photo finish pass. Let's watch him. Of the Hornet routine today. Lieutenant Lindahl will give us another final carrier break for landing, but this one is the one that you will tell your kids about someday. Let's watch him as he sets up here from the right with the F-18. See that one up close? He was looking down the whole time. Did he miss it? Let's do it again, one more time. This is for the little boy down here in the front. We're gonna make this happen. Now pay attention here because you don't want to miss this one. Scott says he's really gonna bring the heat this time. Let's see it. Scott Lindahl, Lieutenant Scott Lindahl from the Hornet TAC demonstration team, circling back around for another photo pass here. You don't get to do this every day. Oh, you have to wait 5 years and wait for Pax River. This is the fifth year they've had off from air shows. We're so happy to be doing it this year. We're gonna make it count, okay? Look at this, he's coming right around from the control tower here. You can see the folks at the tower waving. Scott Lindahl really bringing the speed now from the left. Here it is, folks, the final Hornet pass. Today's demonstration is one that is regularly used in fighter, attack, and aircraft carrier landing missions. It takes many dedicated and talented young individuals to maintain fix and fly of these sophisticated machines, Lieutenant Lindahl and VFA-106, the Hornet demo team, would like to first and foremost thank the people serving at the nation's armed forces. In addition, they'd like to thank all the folks right here at the Pax River Air Expo and Lexington Park and the great state of Maryland for the opportunity to perform here today. On behalf of the United States Navy, Commander Strike Fighter Wing at Lexington. And they certainly hope you enjoyed the show. What did you think of that, Pax River? Wasn't that incredible? Lieutenant Scott Lindahl, and let's not forget Nick up there. Nick Green doing a nice job up there, providing the backup duties. Nice job by the Gladiators and the Hornet demo team. Great job. We're going to close it out with some awesome action, including some former Navy SEALs that want to jump out of a great helicopter up there. We're talking about the Patriots. They are here. They'll actually fly their parachutes upside down in a few minutes. You don't want to miss this. The Black Daggers are back. Plus Art Knowles and the Sea Harrier. And we're going to close things up with the fifth generation fighter from your United States Air Force. I'm talking about the F-22 Raptor demonstration. And the Heritage Flight. Inbound, we have a North American P-51 Mustang. We're going to pair it up with the F-22 Raptor for a moving tribute to all of our veterans, past and present, the little deal we call the Heritage Flight. It's going to be a great time. We hope you stay with us. Now, let's continue to turn our attention towards the sky and wait the arrival of the Patriots and the Black Daggers. We're just a few moments out.